In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create a 3D stroke logo animation in After Effects without using any plugins. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial and let's get to it. First, I'm going to create a new composition. Name it render. It will be 1920 by 1080, 30 frames per second and 10 seconds for the duration. Then open our 3D renderer tab and set renderer to classic 3D, then click OK. Now let's drag the logo to the timeline. You can press S on the keyboard to adjust the scale if needed. I'll leave mine as it is. After you adjusted the scale, right-click the logo and select Precompose. Let's name this Precomp logo and make sure Mobile Attributes is checked, then click OK. Now while the logo composition is highlighted, let's go up to Layer and select Auto Trace. And these are the settings that I'm using to outline the logo, and you can see it from the preview. So you might need to play around with the values to outline your logo. This depends on the type of logo that you're using. And then simply click OK. That creates masks outline of the logo. Now we can go into the effects and presets window and search for stroke, then add the stroke to the logo composition. Here in effect controls, we're going to adjust a couple of settings. Now if you have multiple masks in your logo composition, you simply click the check the box for all masks. So here I have one mask, so I can just leave it as it is. Let's set the brush size to be 15, then brush hardness to be 50%. And for the paint style, make sure you set it to on transparent. Now let's move the time indicator at the start of the timeline. Let's create a keyframe for end and set it to 0%. Now let's move to the end of the timeline and set end to 100%. That gives us a simple stroke reveal like this. At this point, we can create a background. So layer, new solid. Let's name this one BG. And for the color, I'm using the light gray and click OK. Make sure to place the solid layer below the logo composition. Now we're going to create depth in the logo by extruding it on the Z-axis, and the approach we use is a very interesting one. So first we need to create a camera. So layer, new camera. I'll select the 35mm preset, click OK. And we need to make the logo layer 3D by checking this box. If you do not see those columns, click toggle switches and modes until you do, and then check the 3D for the logo to make it into a 3D layer. Now I'm going to select the camera orbital and slightly rotate the camera so we can see the logo from the bottom. Here, I'm switching back to the selection tool. Now, let's select the logo composition and press P on the keyboard to bring up position. Then right-click on the position and select separate dimensions. Then click away so you're not selecting anything. And the one we need is the Z position. So hold the Alt key on the keyboard and click the stopwatch for Z position. Here, I'm going to type index times 3. Then click away. And what this little expression is going to allow us to do is once we duplicate the layer, it will automatically move by 3 points on the Z-axis. And just if we create 20 or 30 copies, we should get nice extrusion in our logo. But before we start duplicating, we need to do one more thing. Let's go to Effects and Presets window and search for Levels. Let's add Levels effect to the logo composition. And we're going to set the output Y to be 160. And that will darken it down and it will all make sense in just a bit. Let's create the first duplicate. So select the logo layer and it'll go up to layer duplicate or press Ctrl D as a shortcut. So that's what I'll be using for now. Now let's select the bottom logo layer and rename it to shadow. Then open the effects drop down, open stroke, hold the Alt key and click the stopwatch for the color. Now make sure you select the logo composition so it appears in effect controls. And what you need to do is for the shadow layers stroke color, you'll find this pick whip tool here. So you need to click on it and drag it to the logo layer's stroke color. So drag it here and let go. That'll link the colors together and it'll make it easier for you to change all colors at once in the future. So here, simply click away and that's done. Now we can start duplicating layers. So I'm going to select the shadow layer and press Ctrl D as many times as you wish. So I'll create maybe 20 copies. And as you do, you can see that the logo is getting extruded and you can stop whatever you feel like. It's enough. So maybe 26 copies is enough. Now I'm going to select the logo composition here and I'm going to remove the levels effect from it. And you can see we've created this perception of shadows. So we have original color, in this case white, in the first layer at the top, and all the layers underneath that are darkened down thanks to the levels effect that we applied. Now let's create extra shadows, like a drop shadow. For that, we need the last layer at the bottom. So let's scroll all the way down and select the last layer at the bottom. Let's remove levels effect from it. Then let's search for CC Radial Fast Blur. in vectors and presets. So add it to the bottom layer. Here, the color is still linked to the original logo layer. So hold the Alt key and click the stopwatch to remove the expression. And once you do that, you can change the color. And let's set the color to be black. Now let's set amount for the CC radial fast blur to 75. And you can already see the shadows. And we can select the center point here and place it into the top right corner like that. Or you can play around with the angle if you wish to do so. And that creates nice shadows, as you can see. So if we scroll forward, this should make the scene look a lot better. And all that's left is to create camera angles and animate the camera to create movement in the scene. But first, let's select the shadow layer at the bottom, scroll all the way up and select the logo layer, just to create to pre-compose them all into one. So right-click any of them, pre-compose, and let's call this one all logos, click OK. And now we need to make this layer 3D by checking the box and also continuously rasterize icon here. So make sure that is checked and the extrusion is back, as you can see. Now I'm going to move the time indicator at the start of the timeline. Select the camera, open up the properties, transform, create keyframes for point of interest and position. Now I'm going to select the camera orbital. Here I'm going to hold the Alt key on the keyboard and use the right mouse button to slightly zoom into the scene. Like that. Then let's move to the end of the timeline. And here you can, you know, change up the angles and play around with, different camera angles to find something that you like. Now you can move the camera to the side. There's something like that. You don't have to copy me exactly. I'm just showing you the way. And that's what we've created. Remember that we link the colors together to make it easy for us to change all colors at once. So I'll show you what I mean. If we open the All Logos composition, then select the logo composition at the top. And for the stroke color, let's select a different color. So maybe this light blue, click OK. Now let's go back to the render composition and the color has been changed and you can see the perception of shadow has stayed with it. And that is it for today. I hope you enjoyed and learned something new in this tutorial. Thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next one. Peace out.